Hello, beautiful people. Today we're gonna play with blood money. This is one of this leader's ability, which is pretty much, I would say, forgotten. I would say definitely bounty right now, it needs a buff. It received this buff for witch hunter executioners, but I would say like 5 for 5, it's still not doing pretty much anything for the deck. It's not competitive anymore, as you probably remember, for all the guys who are playing in this game for a couple of years. Back in the days, it was the strongest deck out of Syndicate, but unfortunately right now, I would say like it's way behind regarding the other decks with Syndicate. So let me just walk you through the cards and let's discuss the strategy. Leader ability, in our case obviously it's gonna be a blood money. It will give us this opportunity to destroy one of the opponent's unit. Tiger's Eye, just to get coins. Oneiromancy for consistency. Brute, one of our last saves in the game. You need to hold this card pretty much to the very end of the game, just to get enough profit, and also so this card can be boosted. The Witcher Finder, this is a super strong card regarding this deck. If it's not destroyed or it's not locked, it can create crazy value for us, because in every single round we are giving a status of bounty on the opposite side of the board, which is like pretty, I would say, superior. And what is also important is that we are getting also 3 coins, so that's the story behind the Witch Finder. Portal, just to get 2 of our 4 provision cards, so this is a good tool regarding our deck for thinning. Scoundrel, super amazing card. Don't be afraid to play this card early in the game. That will give you a super advantage, and then you can definitely bleed in round 2. Ignatius Hail, 9 for 18. This is a super result. It basically doubles the amount of profit regarding points. This is our last say in the game. Graydon, our super removal. It will not be a problem for us to get this bounty status on one of the important units for our opponent and then destroy it. And also with the tribute of 5, we can boost Graydon. So you can imagine that it can go to a crazy value. Caleb Mench, also a super strong card, also super important. Usually if in one round you play Caleb, you don't play Witchfinder, obviously if you have both of them, then you are safe, because you will always have this opportunity to place a bounty status on the opponent. This is a super important card regarding our deck, and it gives a lot to us. Freak Show, this is a removal. Tamara Stranger, also an amazing card, but the problem with Tamara is that it needs to be played early in the game. Octavia Hale, this card here is mainly for consistency. By utilizing her, we can get 2 of the sons of her. Usually we will end up in a situation in which we already have 1 of them in hand, but just to be sure that we are getting all 3 of them, because they are super important for us. We have Octavia here in the deck. Purge, this is the first crime card in our deck. Then we have removal tools, so it's gonna be executioners. Slender, another crime, which is also important. It plays bounty. Hysteria, also a card which is needed for us to place a bounty. Then Confession Extractor. This is basically a card that you would like to start the round with. By doing this, not only you will get coins, but also automatically when one of the opponent's card will get a bounty status, it will be damaged by 1 point. Then another removal, so Bare Knuckle Brawlers, and 2 another 4 provision cards. So as you can see, you can get Vigilantes or Bare Knuckle Brawlers by utilizing the portal. This deck is pretty consistent. What was missing in the other version of Blood Money, and what I can see when somebody is playing this, he's missing a lot of consistency. The thinning is very low, and that's why I decided to include Oneiromancy here, and also a portal. And I didn't want to include the Royal Decree, because I would say that portal is pretty important for us. The 4 provision cards, they don't have any kind of deploy ability. That's why they can be drawn by a portal without any consequences for us. I would say that what would change a lot in this deck would be if the vigilantes could get to 5 points of power. That would make them more stable and they could stay on a board for more than one turn. That's super important for us. And also regarding the deck, the only thing that we can, you know, think about is maybe decrease the provision of this high provision cards. That would give us the space to include more expensive units, which will be a game changer for blood money. So this is definitely not a meta deck. This is a deck in which basically you will be winning with several points. You cannot expect something like you will win with like a great I would say advantage. So here the details, they really matter, so you have to pay attention to what you're doing in the game. So this is the deck, guys. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you for your time and support. Please like, subscribe and comment, guys. See you in the next video. And the last announcement, please go to the nearest shelter and adopt a dog. Thank you very much, guys. Bye bye.
poison spell spread?
Be gone. Be gone. In each of us dwells both chaos and order, good and evil.
Linger, doodle, Terry. Won't help you know how.
For thy foul deeds, thou shalt burn.
Job's a job.
Devil seed! Cursed wench!
Welcomes all. All are free to convert.
Thank you. Thank you. That was very kind.
Your play's over, Yellow Belly. Simplest methods yield the best results. The only good human is a dead human.
What? Wind, blow out the flame! Thank you.
Mother Earth has granted you. From you it came, to you it returns.
When in fear, hail is near.
Charming there.
At your age, at 2 centuries, you behave like you were barely one.
I am fruit. Ha!
doodle, Terry. Won't help you nohow.
Evil is a word I have been sighted.
Our work is in harmony.
Huh?
Huh? easy job.
Carry a high price. They pay it always.
Yes. My pace has